Hey YouTubers, it is Color Trivia Saturday. Yes, color today is green. Have you ever been green with envy? Let's hope not. That goes back to William Shakespeare. But you know what? I find that anytime you look up a word origin, you know, if people don't really know where it comes from, they find it in Shakespeare. You could find anything in Shakespeare. It's like he invented language or something. Okay, so evidently, green with envy goes back to Shakespeare. I will just have to take that as truth, because I haven't found any earlier references to it. Love and sexuality. In Persian and Sudanese poetry, dark-skinned women called green women were considered erotic. Which makes me think of the green women in Star Trek. I'll show you the slide. Yeah, very erotic. Okay, and a little interesting fact for the LGBT community, LGBTQ. In Victorian England, the color green was associated with homosexuality. We think of homosexuality and the color pink because of Hitler. He used it at that time with the pink triangle, and that's where we get that. But the green goes back possibly to Oscar Wilde or possibly before, but Oscar Wilde always wore a green carnation. And rumor has it that during the Victorian time, when things were a little bit more uptight, men would wear a green carnation to signify what their preferences were. So anyway, I found that interesting. Okay, here's something about pigment. In the 18th and 19th century, that brought the discovery and production of synthetic green pigments and dyes, which rapidly replaced the earlier mineral and vegetable pigment and dyes. The new dyes were more stable and brilliant than the vegetable dyes, but some contained very high levels of arsenic and were eventually banned. Okay, green 19th century wallpapers were often deadly. Scheele's green was a vibrant, there's a dog here all of a sudden. Scheele's green was a vibrant pigment used for wallpapers, candles, home goods, clothes, and even confections. It was extremely popular, but again, it contained arsenic and led to the deaths of children and possibly Napoleon. By the 1860s, chemists figured out a way to make a more stable green ink that was resistant to destruction and fading and was difficult to counterfeit. So the once slippery color quickly became one of the most ubiquitous, appearing on every American bill. So, the color of money, yeah. Okay, I'm gonna leave you with just a couple of quotes about color in general. Color is the place where our brain and the universe meet. That is Paul Klee. I love that. And this is by John Ruskin. The purest and most thoughtful minds are those which love color the most. I could agree with that because I kind of love color a lot. Anyway, I hope you guys have a colorful weekend. Go find some green. I will talk to you guys later.